So today we're going to do a simple little demonstration. We're just going to work out how big a voltage we can get on this Van de Graaff generator. You've seen this before in previous demos. All I'm going to do here is turn it on and see how long a spark I can make. So let's think about what's happening here. When I have the belt on, the belt is pulling electrons out of the Van de Graaff, and when I have the grounding rod here, as it pulls electrons out of the Van de Graaff, the electrons are flowing back in through the grounding rod. Now, as soon as I take the grounding rod off, the only way that the electrons can get from the grounding rod to the Van de Graaff is via making a lightning bolt. And so that's what you see happening there. In a second, we'll look at this in the dark, which will make it easier to see the lightning bolt itself, but you can hear it every time it sparks. And right there, there's a lightning bolt that's going about 15 centimeters through dry air. And the breakdown voltage of dry air is 33,000 volts per centimeter. So that's roughly 500,000 volts. So 500,000 volt potential on that Van de Graaff just before the spark goes off. If I come in there, you can hear the spark much more frequently. That's because I'm so close now that the spark will happen when there's only maybe 100,000 volts on the Van de Graaff, and that is much more quickly built up between one spark and the next. When I go back out here, the sparks are less frequent because I need a larger voltage before the air breaks down and you get that lightning bolt. So now let's try this again, but this time in the dark. So here we have, in the dark, a lightning bolt. Smaller than a lightning bolt from a thunderstorm, but it is still pretty impressive. I would say that's almost 20 centimeters, certainly 15 centimeters. And so what's happening here is that as the belt is spinning, it's sucking negative charge out of the Van de Graaff, making it very positive. And that positive charge is in turn sucking negative charge out of my grounding rod in the form of a lightning bolt. You can see it. You can see the beautiful plasma discharge with lots of little fingers of smaller arcs. And if that's 15 centimeters and the air is dry, and in fact today the air is pretty dry, that's about 500 kilovolts, because it's 33 kilovolts per centimeter for air to break down like this. So we are talking about a 500 kilovolt potential on that Van de Graaff right about now. And I'll just show it to you from different angles so that you can see these beautiful lightning bolts. And I'll come back over here to where I started. And I'll see how long I can make them. The farther back I go, here, that's about the edge right there. We go. That's about the farthest, longest I can make them. If I come in closer, they'll become much more frequent because the Van de Graaff discharges when it's picked up a much lower voltage. Right now it's discharging when it's only about 100,000 volts. But now it has to get to 500,000 volts before it discharges. And there it goes.